Hi, this is a beginner's tutorial, and I want to bring forward right now how important it is to resize your designs proportionally. And what that means is making sure that everything gets resized in relation to each other. And it's important for this design because there's a little cardinal that needs to be the same size as the cardinal that it gets glued to in this design. So you can see that right now this is a very large design. And I'm just going to click the lock button, which is going to lock the proportion. And now all I need to do is click one side, change the size, and it changes everything proportionally. And that's also because everything is still grouped from the import. So now I'm going to ungroup it. And you can see that until I click outside the group, I can start separating the layers. Now you can see that that layer has the base for the cardinal. And what we're going to do is we're going to cut out each layer and that separate cardinal. All of the layers are different colors right now. So what happens when you have different colored layers is when you go to make it, it's going to require that you change your mat size for each line. So what I'm going to do is change my layer colors to all be the same color. You may have downloaded the version that has all the same color, and then you would just want to select the element, that little cardinal element, and change that one thing. But so what I'm doing here is I'm just selecting everything but the cardinal and changing it to a gray color. And what this, the value of this is that when I choose make it and I go to the next step, I only need to format my board, the material size, one time, because everything that is that color in this version of the software now is updated. So when I scroll down to my cardinal, you can see it's the only thing that's still 12 by 12 by default. Everything else is now 8.5 by 11, which is perfect because that's my cutting size. Okay, here are all of the layers that I cut. And to start, I'm going to glue the red cardinal onto the base of the white cardinal. And that's going to allow the cardinal to be a different color than everything else. So I'm using, what is this? This is a Ziggs paper glue pencil. You can use any kind of glue. I've used glue sticks, and that's basically it. So now I'm just going to put my layers in order. Oh, I'm missing a layer. Let me go get that. Okay, here we go. Here's my missing layer, and we'll just put them in the way that I like them. I always start with everything in the order that I'm going to be putting it together. And this is the way that I like it. You can flip these around. You can do it however you want, really, but this is just the way that I like it. Then I take my layers and I put them upside down so that now all I have to do is do each layer. What I'm doing is I'm taking off a bunch of one side of the double-sided adhesive strips so that I don't have to pick it apart as I go. I just like to get a lot of it out of the way. So I'm just gonna do that real quick. And then I'm gonna speed up the video because it's a lot of the same. I put down the adhesive. Oh, first let me just make sure my lights work. These lights are a little short. Usually I use 7-foot lights. These are 3-foot lights. This is what I had. Also, this adhesive strips that I'm using, these adhesive strips are 3-inch adhesive strips. I usually use 5-inch. It gives me a little bit more coverage, and it holds down the lights in the corners a little bit better. Anyway, I'm going to speed up this part so that you can see it is the adhesive strip, some lights, a layer. Adhesive strip, some lights, a layer. And it just keeps going and going and going. You can see here that I'm going to use the tackiness of the adhesive strips to help me keep the lights in place. And I'm going all the way around the outside, but I'm making sure that the copper and the wires are not showing up in the picture. I realized after I was finished that I didn't light this the way that I would have liked to light it. So I'm going to show you how I should have lit it, not how I did light it. See that line right there? I really should have just taken the wire, the lit wire, and just sort of brought it right across the mountain so that it would backlight the next mountain. But instead, I wound it all the way around my design again, which isn't terrible, but I don't have a lot of lights. Let me speed this back up again. It still turned out pretty good. In retrospect, I would have done it differently. That's all I'm saying. And right here, this line is where the lights would have gone straight across, which would have backlit that layer of mountains. But you'll see that I do remember that's how I like it. And I did go straight across for the next layer of mountains. Like I said, it's more adhesive tape and then layer. And this is our cardinal layer, which I really like, but I have run out of lights. So I'm just going to light that one side. And then adhesive tape, the double-sided adhesive, and the last layer. So that's it. Ta-da! Let me just dim the lights and show you the effect of the shadow box. Now, because this is a beginner video, I'm just going to show you really quick how I put the shadow box into the shadow box frame. This is an 8x8 frame that I bought at Michael's. You can see that these wires that hang over, I just bend them back so that they don't get caught up or pull at all, and then push the shadow box paper cardstock down into that insert so that the first layer is up against the glass. And then I just put the backing on and, you know, these little things that hold the backing on, and that's it, all done. And that is how I make the Cardinal Birch Tree Shadow Box. I hope you enjoyed this video.